just the way you move will inspire people to want to know more about Islam. Mm-hmm. Habibi, I believe that one of the first steps is the haters who hate Islam. You know, to minimize that hatred is of great success in da'wah, because the ultimate guidance of shahada comes from Allah. Innaka la tahdi man ahbabta. You know, you won't guide whom you love, but Allah guides whom He wishes. So when someone really hates Islam, if you relentlessly and continuously, you know, prove that, you know, you're a good person and the teachings are beautiful and so on, automatically their hatred would diminish. The diminishing of the hatred of a hater is a great success in da'wah. A lot of people don't think of that. Secondly, when a person is close to Islam, to bring them right to the door is da'wah. That might have to happen verbally. It might have to happen, but it does happen with an honesty, with so many other things. I mean, look at how in Western countries, a lot of the times when there is a time of need and the Muslims go out to help, there are people who come and they want to accept Islam because they never guessed that Muslims would do this. They always had the wrong picture. So one action from you proved to them that whatever they had in their minds was wrong, and they came. And thirdly, those who are Muslims, to bring them into the proper fold. You know, like I was saying, when I have events, I normally like to look at it and see, you know, though if people outwardly don't look like they're practicing, I say, oh, mashallah, you know, at least we've reached a lovely crowd of brothers and sisters. We're not going to judge them, but, you know, perhaps may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala make it easy for us and them.
Yeah, most definitely.
And this is one of the things that I have actually developed over time. When it comes to da'wah, when it comes to the field, non-judgmental. Completely. You never know what's going to happen. I've seen miracles. Brother Musa, we were talking about someone who was a belly dancer. And you know what? This person actually bought a ticket to one of the events, came in to say the shahada. And the brother was telling me, you know, just a few days ago, I was judging this person, thinking, oh, look at this person. And the strange thing is, Allah brings people you wouldn't imagine. If you judge them, and you, and this is why, you know, we live in the Western world. Acknowledge people, smile at them, you know, greet them, respond sometimes to that greeting. Meaning, you know, when I say sometimes, I mean you have to respond. And at the end of the day, make them feel human, make them feel you care. I spoke in one of my talks yesterday, and I said, this raddu salam and salam is such an important thing to greet someone. The Prophet ﷺ has given it so much of importance. The Quran has given it so much of importance. Do you know, primarily, people lose their faith because of loss of identity. When you greet the people around you, they feel connected to you. There is an, every day you pass someone on the train station and you greet them, salam alaikum, how are you? And you're gone. Salam alaikum, you're gone. You know, they feel connected to you. They feel this, I'm part of a broad family. That's one of the biggest attractions of Islam and the Muslims, is everyone supposed to be one big family. Shaitan's plan and plot is to split us into millions of small groups.